Hey there, cool teachers. How's it going?
Oh, what a day.
It's the end of the day. Thanks for hanging out with us, little cool teacher extracurricular. We talked about in the cool teacher show a couple of different possible quizzes that you could give your students that would help you understand more about them.
Why would I want to know about my students? What do I care?
Exactly. You know, they either do the work or they don't do the work.
Get it done.
But as you know, there are all these different types of people in our classes.
Yeah. And it helps to know what they're what makes them tick or click.
Some of them are more John Keating, others are more Severus
Snape.
Yes, thank you very much. And they all have different needs and stuff like that. So, we've got two different tools that you can give to them. One of them will kind of seem pretty straightforward, very scientific. The other one, also scientific, might actually surprise you.
Okay.
So, let's talk about personality. And let's talk about rewards.
Personality. Do, 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 do. Personality.
That's not a real song, is it?
Yes.
Does it normally come in a key?
Oh, I have to do that?
Oh, yeah. Is this what I thought?
Okay, let's go with it.
Okay.
Myers-Briggs.
Some of you are familiar with the MBTI, the Myers-Briggs typography indicator, right? It's a personal or personality inventory. Have you ever taken it before?
I have.
Okay.
It's been a long time, though.
It's been a long time. And we're not going to take them here, but we're going to introduce you to them. And basically, they're, the test aligns you with C.G. Jung's psychological types. This spectrum is a really interesting one, and we'll kind of show you what it looks like. Basically, it puts you on this this scale,
right?
And basically takes into consideration whether you're an introvert, whether you're an extrovert.
Let me guess what you are.
Well,
you're a super extrovert.
Super extrovert.
Okay.
So and helps to make sense or to describe the way that people are different. What's nice about this is we found a version of this that can be at Humetrics, and the link is in the description below. And your students can take this test very quickly and easily to determine what type
human metrics. All right.
And so we're not going to take this here, but it's some simple questions. I'll give you just a couple of examples. You are almost never late for your appointments.
I wish I could.
Right. So it, in essence, a 5-point Likert scale, although it's not numbered. And you answer these questions, and it will place you in one of these 16 personality types. So let me just give you an example of one of these potential results. That you could be classified as an INTJ, an introverted, intuitive, thinking, judging personality.
Okay.
Right? To outsiders, the TJs may appear to project an aura of
definiteness
or self-confidence, right?
Okay.
You know, but that's sometimes mistaken as arrogance, right? So it gives this really detailed description of kind of what makes this person tick, what they like, what they don't like, situations they do well in, situations they don't. This might be a nice tool for classroom teachers to just kind of get a sense of who their people are. So you know who you can pair together. Know who you need to maybe keep apart, how to partner people so that they have, so they fill in each other's gaps if they're doing work together. And even, and heaven forbid, identify people who probably are not well suited for group work, who would not prefer that.
Then you may want to let them do a project on their own.
Yep.
And there's nothing wrong with that.
It's exactly right. And so something like this might be meaningful to you. So basically,
and it'd be meaningful to the students, though,
I think
too.
So.
They might think, oh, I didn't realize I was like that. I kind of like to be more like this or something.
Yeah.
Who knows?
It's really interesting. I took the Myers-Briggs when I was in college, and it was a wonderful thing to figure out. No surprise, I was a little bit of an extrovert.
Right.
So the next one that we have for you may seem a little bit strange. I'm going to introduce you to the Brain Hex survey.
I like that name,
right?
Brain Hex.
Now, here's what Brain Hex is. Chris Bateman, who is the author of this Brain Hex player archetype survey, it's for video games. Bear with me here.
Okay.
This is all going to connect here in just a second. But the way that we play video games and select video games and choose to be rewarded in video games says an awful lot about the reward pathways that work best for us. So by taking this quiz, it will brand you with a class and a subclass. So you might be a conqueror achiever, the conqueror class and the achiever subclass. So conqueror, you like engagements, playful engagements where you have the opportunity to compete with others. You don't have to always win, but you like to be able to measure yourself against others. An achiever subclass is more of someone who likes to collect things that are collectible. You know, a badge for completing this, a badge for completing this. Some people are rewarded that way. I don't think you would be. You might be more like a...
I don't care if I get right. an award or not.
I think you're more of a player.
If I did it and I liked the way I did it, right. I'm glad I did it.
You're glad you did it. You're probably more interested in the kind of exploring, seeing what's there. Mm-hmm. And if you were playing a game, you might play the same game that I would play, but you would play it because you're more interested to find out what's in every room rather than can I beat the guy in the one big room.
That's good. Right? I'm glad you know right. a little bit more. You know more about me than I thought you did.
I do. We don't play video games together.
No.
But we should.
I don't
should.
Play video games, period.
We need to fix that, we are on a future episode.
Okay.
So the idea here is that your students could take the Brain Hex survey and you could find more about how the pathways are being
what makes
rewarded.
Them tick?
Here's what's really interesting. Recently, Bateman and Leonard Knack, just a couple years ago, did some correlations with brain neurobiological research with the amygdala and reward pathways, and correlated the biochemical reactions when you achieve one of these things. So,
wow,
we can.
That's complicated.
Yeah, it is. It is.
Duh.
And it's super interesting to me based on what I'm interested in and do. But the point being, if we have a better sense of what rewards our students, this is the big piece here, then we can build activities that reward them in ways that they prefer to be rewarded. Because those rewards are stronger for those different archetypes based on the type of reward they get.
Choice in school. Choice in learning.
Heaven forbid.
Wow.
Anyway,
I like it.
These are the two. Give your students the Myers-Briggs, which is there's free versions of it, and we just showed you those, and give them Brain Hex. You'll learn so much more about them by doing that.
I like that name, Brain Hex.
Brain Hex.
I don't know why. I don't know. It just has a nice sound to it. Is it time to go?
Yeah, I think it's time to go. Thanks for hanging out with us. We'll see you next time.
Bye.
Bye.
We'll be right back.